is pretty much selling his...
What's he selling now?
You haven't seen this yet?
The big sock is gone, right?
Oh, boy.
The sock has got to be gone.
Me and Travis were talking about this.
What now?
Just before you arrived. It's deeply depressing. Kurt Schilling and his video game company went...
Not for Yankee fans.
Went balls up.
For Yankee fans, it's funny.
A huge bankruptcy case. And now it's gotten down to the point he's selling almost everything in his house.
Oh, boy.
I'm looking for the list right now.
He got himself in such bad fucking debt with that dumb video game idea he had.
Former Boston Red Sox pitcher Kurt Schilling, whose video game company collapsed into bankruptcy last year, prompting a high-profile lawsuit in Rhode Island, is selling off furniture, sports collectibles, and even artificial plants from his Massachusetts home.
What?
This is how bad it's gotten.
Artificial plants?
Oh, my gosh. And
an estate sale company has scheduled a sale of items from Schilling's 7-bedroom, 8,000-square-foot Medfield residence for Saturday. So this Saturday, if you're in the area, you could get sofas, porch rockers, candlesticks, a baby grand piano, a punching bag, a Hummer golf cart.
Got a good workout, that punching bag.
Yeah. Fucking asshole video game idea.
An empty tissue box.
Fuck Mario Brothers. Fuck Grand Theft. What else? Where was I? A baseball glove chair.
Oh, that's got to be great.
And a vintage Coca-Cola vending machine.
Oh.
But that's not all.
Yeah, it gets a lot worse than that.
Really? Mm-hmm. Where do I go now here?
Well, let's see. I don't know if it's... For the thrifty spenders.
Yeah.
He's got some low-cost items.
Like?
DVDs, like The West Wing.
He's selling his copy of The West Wing.
How much?
DVD.
No way.
It's probably about $10, I would guess.
No way is he doing this.
He could use $10.
Will he be there or no?
He's selling his baseball bobblehead collection.
Those bobbleheads are pretty popular items.
He's selling his copy of World of Warcraft.
I bet he is.
Like just the game.
I bet he is, because that's what fucked him over.
This is unbelievable.
And
why would you put all your money into one?
Oh God!
Anyone that has like financial people, they always tell you got to kind of diversify.
Diversify.
Got to put a little here, put a little there.
Damn.
I said to Sam this morning, I'm like, this is what like a kid would do if he got a lot of money. Like, I'm gonna make a video game company.
Right.
Yeah.
And he
lost millions of dollars.
He had
millions and he lost it all.
He lost, I think, up to what's the number now? He invested $50 million in 38 studios and has lost all the money earned over his 20-year career. he lost every cent of money he made pitching for 20 years.
Wait, in 38 studios? He had that many studios building this?
No, I think it was called
30.
Okay. I think it's 35. All right, I mentioned it.
The company's 38 studios,
so
yes.
But what a dope
his
to do
number.
That. $50 million?
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
I guess his home he bought from Drew Bledsoe for $4.5 million. He's selling it for $3 million. You know, it's just a $1.5 million loss.
He just needs the cash.
He tried to sell it a couple years ago for $8 million, but nobody wanted it.
Oh, my God.
Because it had all this stuff in it. Now he's getting rid of all
this
junk.
Nice day to pick it up and carry it. It's nice and empty.
And then there's another angle where Rhode Island itself owes $90 million.
Yeah, they're suing him.
They're suing him for the $90
million. Yeah.
Because they owe $90 million as well. Holy shit.
He's also selling many copies of his wife Shonda's book, The Best Kind of Different, about their son with Asperger's Syndrome.
Oh, God, this just gets sadder and sadder.
Selling his copy?
No, many copies. They have
many
copies. Cases of it in their house that didn't sell.
Right. Oh, no.
And so now he's just trying to sell all these books that nobody wanted to buy in the first place.
Does he just fucking... Wow. He's got to sit there constantly thinking how awful a turn his life took.
He didn't even get to do drugs. He didn't get to be like an alcoholic. You think so?
I go way back with Kurt Schilling. We lost touch many years ago.
Yeah, but that's not how he lost all
his
money.
Throw him a few bucks.
He used to love the drink.
Yeah, you're right. Throw him a few bucks.
Come on, Ope.
In the Rochester years, he loved the drink.
Help him out.
But he didn't like throw it all
away. But I think he found Jesus.
You found Jesus?
Look what Jesus did.
Boy, if I found Jesus and then lost this, I would be fairly upset.
You wouldn't be about the Jesus.
It's a test.
Yeah.
That's what you say. You go, it's a Jesus is testing us.
Wow. Well, the company that's in charge of this, the sale, says downsizing is a part of life.
He lost $50 million, and they're saying that's all the money he earned.
Yeah.
He must have earned more than $50 million in his career.
Screw your dumb dream of being the next fucking World of Warcraft guy or EverQuest or something.
Or put a taste into it.
Yeah.
Right.
Put $5 million in it.
Yeah, you could tell your friends, yeah, I'm into this game company.
Put 10% of your worth in there, maybe.
Yeah, how about just be part owner instead of...
Yeah, a little taste, maybe.
You just started seeing movie money go and then just couldn't accept that he was going to lose $3 million.
Oh,
fuck it, I got...
no.
Like, maybe he saw money going and just kept throwing money in to try to stop the bleeding, and it just...
This is one of the worst things ever to happen to an athlete.
I don't know how to feel, because I hate Curt Schilling because he beat the Yankees. Yeah. But then again, I don't want to see a guy's life ruined.
He's a nice man.
Is he really a nice man?
Yeah, he's very nice.
Okay.
When I knew him back in the day, he was a very nice dude. A solid dude, Curt Schilling.
When he was up here promoting his game, he was a very nice dude.
Oh, do we have audio of that?
I think so. I think I brought in Cooks before.
Oh, no, and he talks about his game.
I need him talking about this game that was going to set the world on fire.
It's going to be great.
Yeah, I'm sure he regrets signing the ball I had for him for free.
You have a Curt Schilling signed ball?
Yeah, but
he might want that back.
Yeah.
Why don't you give it back to him?
Yeah,
I'll just send him $10.
Right.
Send him a copy of The West Wing.
You could get, yeah.
It's probably possible to get him to sign one now.
I bet. If he's selling $10 DVDs, you get that fucking ball signed.
He's really selling $10 DVDs?
Yeah, he's selling The West Wing.
Why doesn't he set himself up with like a fucking, you know, how they go out and just have shit signed? Like, he'll sit there and just sign a bunch of shit for some cash.
I'm sure he's doing all that, but he owes so much fucking money.
Yeah.
How many baseballs are you going to sign to make $90 million?
Just one for $90 million. No.
And he bought his house back in the day from good old Drew Bledsoe.
Yeah, we were just talking about that.
Did you say that?
Yeah.
What'd you say? What did I miss?
$4.5 million.
Yeah, we just said that.
Oh, and selling it for $3 million?
Yeah.
Holy fuck, are you serious?
Yeah, then Anthony said, that's just a $1.5 million loss.
Oh, my God, I'm sorry.
And I remember thinking...
I'm heating up. I feel like an idiot.
I this is how specific that was. I almost said, like, oh, that's. I almost did a literal gym when you said that.
Oh, that is a lot of money.
Yeah. Oh, but yes. No, that's really a loss.
That's a lot.
Wow, so...
How do you like?
But if he gets the $3 million on the house, he has to get rid of that too.
Well, you know, he tried to sell it for $8 million a few years ago, but nobody wanted it.
That's what Travis said. Oh, Travis. Yeah.
We can look. Everyone's confused today.
Oh my God! Sorry about that.
You want to look at his stuff online?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh yeah! 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 I want to see it. Let's bid on it.
Like, his dream came true. He got to be the one in a billion who gets to play for the Boston Red Sox.
Dream come true.
And then everything collapsed anyway.
Where did he come out of?
Some 18 years ago, I left Dayton, Ohio, with two very bad knees. And a dream to become a Major League Baseball player.
Apparently, that dream is pretty fucking powerful.
I thank God this dream came true.
What is that?
Flubber hats?
He's selling flubber hats.
What is that?
Are they signed?
Yeah.
Yes. I don't know by who.
He signed flubber hats.
No, it doesn't look like.
It looks like Robin Williams.
What?
Robin Williams.
He was in the movie Flubber.
He was in the movie Flubber.
You're right, Robin Williams.
You look at that quick, though. That looks like a Curt Schilling.
No, he's selling.
But now I see Robin Williams.
Robin Williams.
Because if you have Robin Williams' autograph,
flubber hats.
You want it on a flubber hat.
So he probably got a couple of these flubber hats from the movie Flubber. And Robin Williams.
You guys can both buy one.
How much? What is that? A bunch of baseballs.
Sports. Is that a cassette tape?
These are
case.
That's a cassette tape.
What is this? He's not even displaying his stuff properly.
The Paul Pitcher's story. And there's a phone number on it.
No.
Which they probably shouldn't.
Oh, no. Whose phone number is that?
Doesn't matter. E-Rock. We won't talk about it.
Wow. This
Whoa.
Is just. He probably didn't take these pictures. This has got to be someone who's just doing this.
This is his
part of the consignment.
You think he just left and they're just doing it?
Ooh, that looks like a good video game.
No.
Wow, what's that video game? I want to play that.
Well, you can probably get it cheap.
Oh.
It's a giant poster for the video game he made.
Is that it? It was called The Reckoning?
Well, it wrecked him.
Yes.
Yeah.
What an appropriate name.
His Coca-Cola machine.
How much is that?
He probably hates selling that.
He probably loves it.
Oh.
How much is that?
I don't know. It doesn't.
I'm going to help an old pal out. Maybe I get a Coca-Cola machine out of it.
These are collectible, and if I could get it for the right price, I want it.
Here's his punching bag.
Oh, boy.
Oh, wow.
Let me ask you about this stuff. Do you go to the house and buy it, or do you...
Oh, yeah. probably be set up like a museum. You walk around.
His backyard furniture. He's selling his backyard patio furniture.
It's just going to be a bunch of creeps walking around his house buying things.
All the family memories that happened there.
He was one of the best.
He won't be there.
I doubt it.
Yeah,
he's too depressing.
Yeah,
he definitely still lives there.
Oh, no.
They don't want to say that, but...
not my toothbrush.
Where else would he be living?
He's got no place else to go.
He can't afford rent.
Dude, he's selling everything.
It's an estate sale. He's selling everything.
That's fucking... Yeah, but why your fucking cassettes?
Oh, my God, that shitty...
plant?
Artificial plant he's selling?
I want that.
It's...
rocking chairs.
He's saw him sell a rocking chair once. More dumb plants.
More horrible artificial plants.
When is this sale happening?
I'm not sure.
Chairs.
Horrible, just bad artificial furniture.
Trees, a mirror, gaudy candlesticks. Mirror.
Oh, his candlesticks have price tags on them.
Oh,
that's his stuff.
Oh, no.
They probably told him, you know, all these little knickknacks add up. People want this kind of memory.
What is that? Those are like old flowers wilting.
Turn it a little bit, Sam. I can't see.
They're terrible.
They almost look like flowers. They almost look just like old flowers.
Oh, that's nice.
What is that, a credenza?
It's a China cabinet.
China cabinet.
That's nice.
Go fast, tea set.
I mean, we got 150 of these things.
I know. Keep going fast.
Oh, my God.
How much is that?
Oh, it's $165 for that vase.
A little vase.
But they'll take less.
Tiffany vase.
And then every time.
Yeah, I think
they'll take less. They want all this sold Saturday.
If you buy it, you could just be like, hey, by the way, you see that vase? You know where I got that? Kurt Schilling's house.
These are custom-made sofas.
Custom
are they?
Made.
You know who they were made for?
Kurt Schilling.
Kurt Schilling. Oh, boy.
Dude, that's a big house.
A lamp.
Yeah.
Well, because he used to be a very wealthy baseball player.
Drapes. Horrible, heavy
selling
drapes.
Selling the drapes.
This is depressing, man.
Go faster.
Just look at
you
all
think
the
his wife just curses the video game?
His piano. His baby grand.
Oil and vinegar.
Oh, no.
Why would that poster, by the way, should be have a big rip in it? Like, why would that poster still be up?
Right?
Yeah. A fucking. You want to buy a reckoning poster with a shotgun hole in it?
It has to be said. People have said that Kurt is one of the biggest assholes in baseball, but
really?
That was not my experience, and it was not Sam's experience when he came in here. He could have been nicer.
Individually priced.
His glasses. Just like fucking
miscellaneous.
Look at all these price tags on drinking glasses.
On his drinking glasses?
All his glassware has sticky price tags on them.
Oh my God.
I bet you the sports stuff goes fast.
Where's it?
Yeah, the baseballs and shit like that.
Where's he going to live after this?
ELO's.
Studios.
Is he on ESPN?
He is an analyst for ESPN, yeah.
That might be a couple $100,000 a year, right?
Hey.
I don't know.
She got the Kurt Schilling chair.
Easily.
Yeah, but now ESPN knows they can get him cheap.
Yeah.
This is all out there. They're going to renegotiate his deal.
Yeah, well, his coworkers should just go buy this stuff and use it in front of him.
What is that?
Look at all these electronics.
I see a lock.
A shitty old camera.
Shitty camera, a fucking
deck of cards.
An old Apple. Old
Apple power supply.
Or a MacBook charger.
Oh, Microsoft Office in the box. There's a deck of bicycle playing cards there.
That's nice. He needs to play some cards.
Yeah.
There's a Boston Red Sox baseball.
Oh.
Remember when he played baseball for the Red Sox?
Yeah.
A lock that probably doesn't have the correct combination.
His microwave.
He doesn't know what it is.
Selling his microwave oven.
And you know you're not going to get more than 15 for a microwave.
Yeah, you can buy a new one.
And you're
one
always
like
going to need a microwave.
Yeah, because wherever he goes to live, he's going to need some of this
need
stuff.
Need a microwave.
He's going to be like, no, we sold it for $15.
What the hell is that?
For some Christmas
decor.
He's selling his holiday stuff. Like, the stuff you keep in a closet until the holidays.
Oh, because there's no Merry Christmas at the Schilling house this year.
Look at all these crutches he's getting rid of.
Oh, probably from when his foot was all fucked up.
Yeah.
All right. That ties into the bloody sock.
He's got terrible Christmas decorations.
He's got bad taste.
Yeah, he's fucking awful.
A lot of this shit is horrible.
Yeah, I would just buy a fuckload of tube socks and a razor blade and just cut myself and stain them with blood and just sell them.
Look at this.
So it's not the sock, but it's my sock. It's got blood on it.
Same thing.
Yeah.
This is a novelty locker that says Schilling on it.
Wow, that's going to be a big
That'd
one.
That'd be cool.
It's depressing they have a son.
His drum set. But it looks like his kid's drum set.
It's like kicked over.
He's even selling his kid's stuff.
I'm assuming his kid's name. Is his kid's name Grant? Because there's a dinosaur with the name Grant written on it.
That's for sale?
Yeah, that's Bob Grant.
Oh, his jackets.
Probably dope jackets in there.
When does this happen?
Horrible towels. Beach towels.
There's that shilling
locker. When is this? Do we know?
Saturday.
Oh, this Saturday.
Look at all those copies of his wife's book that didn't sell.
Who wants to read about that stuff?
I don't know, but they're going cheap.
It's the closet full of books.
Oh, my God.
It's
so what do
terrible.
You do? Do you vacate and they come in and just say, fuck it, and price everything?
I guess an auction house comes in and figures out, you know, how much they get for this shit.
His chair is shaped like a baseball mitt because that's what he used to play in.
That's
and made a whole bunch of money.
The baseball glove chair. How many times do you think he sat in that? Yeah, this is life.
No, those are kids' chairs.
Yeah,
you can tell. Yeah. Those are for the kids.
Yeah, better time.
Oh, he's selling his kids' teddy bear. He's selling his kids' teddy bear.
It's not fun anymore.
This is terrible. A gargoyle, probably from the Reckoning game.
There's a Ms. Pac-Man machine.
Why don't we get a Ms. Pac-Man machine in here?
Should have stuck to just playing that instead of trying to come up with your own game.
Kurt Schilling on the show.
Yeah, meanwhile, he's got like a different version of Pac. I was going to bomb on that.
Yeah, certainly. That was zero confidence.
Yeah, no. I was trying to put it together. Sometimes you just throw it out and put it together as your words are forming.
As you're saying it, yeah.
That was not happening.
Sometimes it doesn't work.
No, I was juggling.
At one point, he was making so much money, he could buy himself a Hummer golf cart.
Yeah,
golf.
Look at that.
Now he's selling it.
Golf cart. Like Fog.
Fog.
The Bambino ice resurfacing machine. What?
Zamboni.
He's selling his Zamboni.
What, did he have a pond out back for hockey?
Probably
he
must a little have. Mini Zamboni he's selling.
That's not a care in the world.
Oh, his fucking lawnmower.
Oh, he's selling his...
The ice mower. There is so much junk. What is that he's selling?
It's a sink and a mirror.
Old school. Those are some antiques.
Oh, God.
Wait a minute. Why would you take a picture? It's an angry bird stuffed animal.
I actually got that. You can't get more than 50 cents for that. Yeah. What is he doing?
It looks like something you win at a carnival.
Yeah.
It's an angry bird ball that you throw around the fucking house.
How much is he possibly going to get for his kids' toys?
This is not cool, man.
Do you think he's on this site right now, too, just looking and having memories all this season?
Oh, I remember that.
Laugh in that chair.
Brand new games. He never got a chance to play these games.
He's too busy making his own.
Right.
Getting ideas.
Yeah.
Oh,
here's the DVDs.
Wow, his DVD collection is pretty sad.
Rome? He didn't even get a chance to watch Rome. And he bought all the DVDs at FYE, which means they're higher priced.
FYE.
World of Warcraft, right there.
How much could you zoom in? How much is he selling them for?
And zoom in. I want to see more of these DVDs.
He's trying to get $35 for Rome. That's not happening.
That ain't happening.
Well, that's two seasons. It's probably not going to happen.
Well, he should be signing all this stuff first.
$20 for Rescue Me.
$20 for Rescue Me is not
Grey's Anatomy.
He's trying to get $30 for his deluxe World of Warcraft.
Oh, God.
Westworld, Slumdog Millionaire.
They didn't even get a chance to watch Slumdog. It's still sealed.
Yeah.
It's a great film.
Can you see any of the other names, or that's about it?
Yeah.
Every season of The West Wing.
Yeah. People will buy this stuff, though, just because it was Kurt Schilling's.
Not if he doesn't sign it. Rescue Me, you said that, right?
Okay. You want a Flubber hat?
No!
Robin Williams signed Flubber hat.
I'd invite my friends over to watch Rome, and then throughout the episodes, just keep reminding them who used to own this copy of Rome.
I know, as you tip your Flubber hats to each other. Yeah. You sat in your baseball glove chair.
Yes.
I want to go on a Kurt Schilling shopping spree.
The whole collection.
I think you should both buy those Flubber hats and wear them when he comes in.
Would be awesome.
Oh, my God.
Dude.
Oh, imagine. Hey, Flubber hat.
Oh, my God.
Could someone buy us the Flubber hats if you go into Kurt Schilling's house Saturday? What else?
Kurt.
We're only halfway through the list.
Oh, that's just depressing.
Oh, look, he's got all these
CDs, games.
He's selling his game of life.
Oh, well, you know what happened there. He ended up in the poorhouse.
Oh, it's the Disney VHS collection.
Nice.
That's his kids' movies.
Yeah. His kids probably outgrew them, though.
Some of these are in the vault.
Yeah, you never outgrow these. Yeah, that's true.
Hercules.
Right.
Shitty movies.
Oh, he's selling copies of Pirates of the Caribbean, two versions of Life After People, Legally Blonde, Full Metal Jacket, Raising Helen. He's selling a copy of the film Rat Race starring Rowan Atkinson.
Not Fred Claus.
Yeah, he's getting rid of his
fever pitch.
You know, he's going to sit home and want to watch Sweet Home Alabama and realize that some asshole came into his house and bought it for 50 cents.
Oh.
Yeah, what can you get for an old DVD?
Nothing. FYE won't even pay for him anymore.
Really?
It's physical media. Nobody wants it.
No one.
That's really rough, man. Yeah.
He should say he's going to sign all of them.
Everything.
Least.
Dude, he should be putting his name on everything.
The fucking doors of the house.
Oh, his music collection?
No, these are
more movies?
Video games.
Oh, video games, okay.
And he loves video game, doesn't he?
Not anymore, I bet.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry. They're all...
There's an empty sleeve. You know what game used to go there?
They're all old CD-ROM games.
Do you think the first time he popped it in, his wife looked at it, she wanted to go, like, oh, this is not very good.
What are you doing? How much of our money?
Yeah, $40 million. But look at this. The demons fall out of the lights.
Oh.
He's selling his copies of Nintendogs.
What?
Nintendogs?
Yeah.
It's a game by Nintendo where you raise dogs.
He really got a little too deep into games.
Stupid.
He's got all these Nintendo DSs, and two of them are customized for the game Nintendogs, which he's selling. He's also selling a PSP.
Dude, I bet he's bummed about this.
I would play Nintendogs if I knew it was Kurt Schilling's copy.
Yeah.
All right, let's go. We're only halfway through.
Oh, it's DJ Hero. Nobody bought DJ Hero.
He can't stop buying games.
Nobody bought that game.
No one bought that.
They had Eminem and Jay-Z connected with it, and still nobody bought
it. No one cared.
Why would anybody? DJing is already a video game. Why do you need DJ Hero?
Well, they were going with the Guitar Hero thing, thinking that they could go to the next level.
It's fine for his kid.
How ridiculous would Kurt Schilling look playing DJ Hero?
Well, what was it for him?
Ridiculous is selling all his shit.
Yeah. Oh, no. What? He's selling Drake and Josh on DVD, the best of seasons 1 through 4.
Holy shit.
The best. And his copy of Mortal Kombat for Xbox 360.
Just tuning in, this is
Kurt Schilling's estate sale that's going down Saturday because he owes a lot of money.
Wait, how did he only make $50 million, but he owes over $100? Like, did he borrow more than he ever made?
Probably.
Yeah, I
couldn't owe twice what he made, does he? Oh, fuck.
We got to crunch the numbers, but maybe, you know, he used his $50 million to get a nice big loan.
What's he got, an old fucking sling box?
A very old sling box. Oh, it's HD ready.
Wow, HD ready.
Oh, good.
Oh, he's got a blanket with a B for Boston and a heart around it.
Okay. That ought to pull in something.
The site says that items are significantly discounted.
His scales?
You want a scale? A bathroom scale?
You shouldn't have bought that many
clothes.
Just piles of clothes.
T-shirts.
So when you walk around Kurt Schilling's house, you can pick up a pile of his clothes.
Look at his socks right there.
Khaki shorts. He's going to want to wear his khaki shorts next summer. And he won't have them because somebody bought them.
He'll be like, where is my cruise wear?
Got a bunch of Boston sports hats. And then a signed EverQuest 2 poster.
Cabana wear.
Who signed that?
I don't know.
8,000 square feet.
Of shit for sale.
No.
What is this stuff?
Sports stuff.
Odds and ends.
They're just calling it odds and ends.
Odds and
They're
ends.
They're just going to throw all this stuff in a box and say everything in here $1 each.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Oh, there's his bobblehead collection.
Bobbleheads.
He shouldn't have started a bobblehead collection in hindsight.
The bobbleheads.
He's got that's all the Arizona Diamondbacks?
Yeah, well, he was on the team.
So he collected the whole team of bobbleheads?
They probably gave them to him.
Mets.
Mm-hmm. And now it's pure profit. He probably didn't pay for those. This is pure profit. Yeah.
It's not profit.
That'll put him over the top.
More just shitty electronics wires.
A nebulizer compressor.
Ooh, that looks like an unopened Xbox.
Oh, he's got all his sports memorabilia McFarlane toys.
Oh,
starting lineup toys.
Look, he's got his Larry Bird action figure that he's selling.
Ugh.
You think Larry Bird would have to sell a Kurt Schilling action figure?
No.
I don't think so.
Jesus.
Poor fella.
What was he thinking?
I don't know.
He wasn't.
He's got his Halo version of the game of Risk also for sale.
Oh, God, all right, with his dumb games.
He spent too much money.
Keep
on tchotchkes.
Tchotchkes.
Scrabble and Risk.
Scrabble.
He bought World of Warcraft, the board game.
It's like, what letters do I have? B-R-O-K-E?
Who's buying that Scrabble?
No one, unless maybe he signs it.
He's got, like, baseball dude sunglasses.
Right, like the Jose Canseco type.
Why does he need a sunglasses. Microscope for? Why did he buy it?
Because he could at the time.
Very good.
He had limitless money until he made that big fucking investment.
He's got a solid toy Millennium Falcon. Loves Star Wars.
Holy fuck.
He's selling his kids' beds.
Oh,
where
no.
Where his kids going to sleep?
Kind of like those sort of bunk beds.
A little, yeah.
Like a loft and then a bed underneath.
He's a little stuffed lobster.
Oh, that's nice.
He's selling a copy of Casey at the Bat.
Bulldog magazine.
And a Bulldog magazine.
All right.
Why wouldn't you just throw out the Bulldog magazine?
Right.
Yeah. Oh, more stuffed
more
Pokemon.
Of his kids stuffed animals.
Not a stuffed Pikachu.
A little stuffed. Anybody want a stuffed Pikachu?
Seriously, $2. $2. Stuffed Pikachu.
Lobster, stuffed frog, stuffed Obama, stuffed.
Is that a.
Yeah.
I guess you can only see half the.
Oh.
Let me.
It just got that.
Selling all his kids' toys.
How much did they expect to get? They said that the sock got 92,000, which was less than expected.
Oh, man.
I can't imagine they get more than a couple hundred thousand Saturday.
No, but Eric, how much were they expecting for the sock, though?
What?
Eric, they got Harry Potter Legos for sale.
Oh.
Get a nice deal.
Well. Kurt Schilling's Harry Potter Legos.
That'd be so dope.
It would be.
Ooh, more Legos.
Oh, it's a Lego Buzz Lightyear. That's not an adult collectible. That's a child's toy.
Kids
are going to want to play Legos.
We still have 50 to go. Let's go.
Oh, my God. More Legos.
Look at all these toys.
All right, now we're in the toys.
A lot of his kids' toys.
What about his kids? Why do his kids' guns?
His kids' fucking toy guns.
Dark guns and pirate swords.
Why do his kids have to sell all their shit?
Transformers. And
individual action figures.
What? You're right. Why does his kids have to sell all their shit? Because he made a bad investment.
Daddy fucked up. Daddy fucked up.
You think there was a little family meeting?
Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Did that wife give him fucking an earful?
His kids got to sell his T-Pain microphone that auto-tunes your voice. You know how much fun he could have had with that?
Yeah.
Oh, the piano from the movie Big.
Oh, you lay it on the floor and you go ding, ding, ding.
No one could actually do that.
No.
Only that one guy could.
Yeah, that was an F.A.O. Schwartz.
Yes.
Yep. Kurt Schilling, I think it's still there.
It is.
Kurt Schilling and his kid definitely can't.
No.
iPhone cases. Not even for a current iPhone.
Maybe you have an old iPhone. Everybody's not fancy with money. Maybe that's from an
Why would they
phone?
Be displaying this like this is a big get?
Well, the iPhone case, the Mickey Mouse case is $6.
All right.
That's probably not going to happen.
Six more bucks in the fucking till?
You think that one's going to get haggled down?
Yeah. Someone's like, I'll give you a buck.
And there's a case of assorted paper clips.
Oh, jeez.
Well, you might need that. I love paper clips.
Who doesn't? Flip tripod.
A tripod for a flip cam. Flip's not even in business.
What? Flip cam went belly up like Kurt Schilling did.
He probably invested a lot of money in Flip.
Right.
Wait a minute now.
All these tripods.
Is Flip cam in there? Like, are there any flip cams in there?
No, just a tripod.
Nobody uses flip
cams. No, they stink.
They used to be great.
They were great, but they always crashed.
I loved Flip.
They came out at the worst.
Worst time.
Right.
Why?
When phones started getting really good cameras.
Just started getting good video
but
cameras.
But the problem with phones is you can't leave your phone somewhere to tape your set.
That's it. Look at that. A bathrobe, 38 Schilling Red Sox bathrobe. That one shouldn't be on the rack
with all
that. Matt
Frost probably makes that.
Yeah.
Matt Frost. When I met Mattingly, I said, yeah, my friend made a robe for you. He goes, Matt, right. He knows Matt Frost makes these he's got the contract for Major League Baseball.
Really? Wow.
Yep, for these robes.
Good for him.
Damn.
It's his idea.
Can he make Robert Reed's?
Didn't need a lot of fabric.
One.
But imagine having the robe that says Schilling on the back.
That's a biggie.
It's actually Schilling's.
Why is that sitting in the rack of other shitty clothes? That should be like displayed like sports memorabilia.
Because he never wore it, probably.
Oh.
Or maybe he wore it every day.
He probably did.
Heated 8-car garage.
Walk around the house.
Nude buttocks.
Mumbling.
Oh, it's his kid's sweater vest.
It's a terrible sweater. I would wear that at a Christmas picture.
Yeah, but his kid's going to be so cold.
Oh, man. What is that? Some kind of lace thing.
Those are accent pillows.
Oh, well.
Oh, my God.
Can't accent anything when you're broke.
They're getting $5 million less than they wanted a couple of years ago.
Oh, the
$5 million less.
Gone. Bedroom set.
Dresser.
Yeah, a little dresser. Is
well, if this is his house, it doesn't look that impressive. But it's a nice house.
Terrible taste.
We've seen pretty much every room now because it's filled with all this shit that he has to sell.
Do you know how bad I want to drive up there just to buy those paper clips? And just use them and tell everyone this used to be Kirk Schilling's paper clip.
He's still focusing on the stupid Rome DVD.
Well, this says DVD's new, but the problem is that he bought it used from FYE.
Yeah.
There's a tag that says used just because FYE reseals it. Now they're trying to resell FYE's used.
I got a question. Could the game ever come back? That he invested in?
Oh, no, it's gone.
Absolutely not.
Just totally done, huh?
Maybe, like, ironically, bankrupt. In 10 years.
Was it really bad, or was it just not as good as...
No one
why
wanted
did it flop?
To play it.
There's an inflatable bottle that says party time on a clock on it.
He's not going to be...
He well, hasn't celebrated not, in quite I some get, time.
Yeah, he's not yeah. into party time
oh,
anymore.
My God. There's no parties going no. on at the Schilling House.
Does anybody know why his game flopped? Like, did it just suck?
It was not good. It got very bad reviews.
And it's a very competitive business.
It got bad reviews, and yeah, like it was kind of like a World of Warcraft game, and when you've got a game that has already established itself as the best, yeah. it's kind of like, why would you use Bing when you've got Google?
Oh, you know? Yeah.
We're
yeah.
trying to come out with like a GTA game now.
Yeah,
that would
exactly.
be just dumb.
Yeah.
Especially when you're not Microsoft, when you're just a dude who happens to have $50 million.
Yeah.
He thought it was like,
it.
Hey, I'm Kurt Schilling, this is going to sell great.
All in. That's
I'm love.
So crazy.
Who does that?
He's not going to be able to play pinball on these machines ever again.
No.
Somebody's going to buy him for almost no money.
It's all fucking
pool table.
Gone.
Pool table. Keep going.
Lord of the Rings pinball.
All right.
Arcade Legends. It's an arcade system one. That's got every
yeah,
game
all the
on
old
it.
Games.
Right. That could be cool.
He loves like, video games. Oh, broken. Boy.
Ping pong table with the net that's down. You see that?
Weights.
His weights.
Oh, his blender. He probably made protein shakes.
His blender.
Keep cool. his strength up when he's fucking...
The Coca-Cola machine.
Playing
again.
Ball.
More couches. Stools.
Bad tables.
This looks like a man cave.
Right. His vacuum.
He's selling his vacuum and his cordless drills. Wow, they have fucking everything must go.
His router.
A router.
His dusty Linksys router.
He's...
Oh,
look at all those drills. You shouldn't have bought so many.
No, why do you need so many cordless drills? Oh, a Boston Red Sox bag. A little yeah, duffel
that
bag.
Stuff you never really
and
used.
It looks
know.
Like a case full of t-shirts. Look at all those tools. What was he fixing? He didn't need to buy all that. That's yeah, I think we've seen the rest.
Yep.
Flubber hat. Back to the flubber hat.
Keep going. That's there's the nine to go. Maybe this is another nugget in there.
Mm-hmm.
All right, baseball.
Baseball.
Some of this stuff
the
is on there twice.
The reckoning poster. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Coca-Cola machine.
The dumb Coke machine.
Oh yeah, the punching bag.
Punching bag.
Table. Yeah.
And his patio furniture.
Yeah, okay, his right. patio furniture. Wow.
Just memories for sale for very little.
Wow, money. That poor fuck. That is terrible.
Let's put that on our Facebook page so people could go through it.
No.
How much could all that make for him?
$50 million.
$50 million.
He'd be lucky to get.
He'd be lucky to get $100,000 for that.
Oh, God, not even.
No way.
Like, for every single thing in the house.
No, not
yeah, because some of those couches and stuff would probably get a few thou.
He'll get 30 grand for everything.
You think 30
yeah,
grand?
Yeah.
When you're totally bankrupt, do they just say, okay, now we're selling everything? That might be yeah. one of the conditions of bankruptcy.
Yeah, now they roll in and they try to get as much of their money back as possible.
Oh, man.
Fuck.
Price to move.
State sale.
I mean, let's say the couches get... $40,000. You've still got to make $60,000
yeah,
to get to 100
true.
Grand. You're not going to do
yeah,
that.
You're right. Really see anything
there. Those couches aren't making any $40,000.
No, absolutely
either.
Not. No,
I'm not paying $40,000 for Kurt Schilling's old couches.
What about the fucking?
God damn.
What about the golf cart and the fucking?
The Hummer
lawnmower?
Golf cart.
Yeah. The Coca-Cola machine.
I give you $700 yeah. for that Hummer golf cart.
Sold.
Okay.
I'll take it.
I would love to know what his perspective is on this. How awful this must feel.
He's kind of happy about it.
Well, yeah, but I mean, what's it? How did this fucking? Where did he realize it was at the point of no return?
Yeah.
Like what happened? Like what
after he
day,
talked to Sam.
Yeah, he realized none of my listeners were buying that game.
Oh, is that how long ago was he in for that?
It was when the game. It was a week before the game came out.
A year
was,
and a half ago, maybe.
That's it.
A year and a half, 2 years.
This all
ago?
Went down to within the last 2 years.
Oh no!
Yeah,
he was pretty excited about the launch of the game.
Oh, he's yeah. pumped. He loved like this is his love. Like he loves these RPGs.
Oh, God.
God.
He loved the idea of creating one, and he was super psyched for this game.
Do you think he had any inkling that it wasn't going to work?
No, he thought it was.
Is there any video online of what this game looked like in-game? I'm curious.
I don't think you go 50 million deep into something you don't have complete confidence
in. No, I mean by the time it came out, though, like, did something happen where he was like,
uh-oh.
But who was advising him?
I know, right?
You can have a lot of confidence, but who's going to tell you, why don't you go all in
with everything you
have in the bank?
Yeah. Oh, boy.
Just wow.
I want to hear a clip of him on your show.
Yeah, I want to hear that.
Knowing now that it all went belly up.
Oh, it went south really quickly. Oh, that poor fuck. He was rich.
I mean, really
fucking
rich.
Should have made a baseball game.
Right?
He knows a little bit about baseball.
Hey, look, it's the Curt Schilling pitch with your bloody ankle game. Yeah. What's this?
Still walk through the video.
A five-minute taste. I'm curious.
Reckoning.
And now, we've got to get you out of there. Here you get your first glimpse of the Well of Souls, the place of your rebirth.
Oh, no. This sounds terrible.
Combat and Reckoning is intuitive and accessible. You can chain together basic attacks with a single button.
Oh. Sell your stuff.
Oh, it's...
Collecting loot is a big part of the game.
Of course.
While you loot, you can compare items and decide whether they are worth equipping now or saving them to sell off later.
It's just the same thing.
Just sounds like an awful...
Just by varying the timing of your basic attacks, you'll perform special moves like launching an opponent into the air and juggling them.
Compared to GTA, though?
Using your shield for a well-timed parry can open up an even more damaging attack chain on your stunned opponent.
You know, IGN gave this a 9 out of 10.
Oh, wow.
Really?
Yeah. Now we fast-forwarded to
the Daemon Domination. You know how crazy he must have been when he heard
that? First introduction to the outside world of Reckoning.
What happened?
It's a peaceful place, a relatively safe start to your hero's journey. You now have both primary and secondary weapons equipped. And even as a melee fighter, you'll unleash powerful battle magic on your enemies.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, it received generally very good reviews. Didn't succeed.
Sometimes you're rewarded with opportunities to dispatch enemies with a special fate shift kill. Building up enough fate energy allows you to perform even more powerful attacks.
Was this online, though, or was it just standalone?
I think it was, like, Xbox.
Reckoning features a robust crafting system. Here, for example, you might try your hand at Sagecraft. Using this altar, you insert a magical gem into a longsword, upgrading it to a more powerful flaming sword.
I don't like the little circle of fire that's always with him. That's irritating. This dumb sword. I heard it.
He's so hot.
Combat and Reckoning is all about the choices
you make. The problem
is,
this has been done so many fucking times already. Yeah. We get it. The mighty fucking epic weapon and the fucking powers and the... Yeah, it's been done 1,000 fucking times.
How about a guy that's running around looking in upside-down hats for gold eggs?
Gold eggs. Why?
Let me go to Adam in Illinois. Adam?
Hey, boys.
Hey, buddy.
Just so you know, Kurt's game can be yours through Sony on PlayStation for free right now.
Oh, no.
It's down to free?
Free.
Absolutely free.
The cost has gone down to free.
Why free?
Because nobody's going to
No one would pay for
it. Can't they just throw him a bone and go, look, everybody.
$3.
$3. Come on, let's help him out a little bit.
Can 20 million of you buy this for a buck?
Right. Wow. Thanks, Adam.
Yep.
This is a horrendous story.
And if it got great reviews and like everyone liked it, what was it that you think just like what?
It's just an unnecessary game. Like it was like there was no sort of like it's good, but there are already good games like that.
Yeah,
I'm already playing that game. It's World of Warcraft.
Yeah, I'm not going to stop playing a game that I've leveled up to fucking level umpteen million to go start. Pounding on rats in town square.
It's like coming out with a delicious cola. However, I already have a cola.
Right.
It's called cum.
That's not cola.
You know how hard it's got to be for this guy to sleep at night? Not only did he lose all that money, he knows that the game got really good reviews.
Yeah.
He's got to be out of his fucking mind.
He made a good game.
Right.
Oh.
Because maybe in the end you lose the money, but, you know, the game was shit. But they're saying that the game was not shit.
Maybe that's the only thing that's keeping him from throwing himself in front of a train.
Wow.
Is that he knows it just didn't work, but it wasn't his fault.
Yeah, but didn't work meaning you lose everything. That's just
lose
insane.
Everything.
Because the guy had enough money to live for the rest of his life very, very well. Oh, and now he's going to be just...
Apparently he was very thrifty with his money looking at his goods.
Right.
We got to get those flubber hats.
He put all his money into that dumb game instead of his house.
I think he's working out, thinking that maybe I could get that fastball up one more time.
He's not working out. He doesn't have any weights.
There you go. Come back as an old pitcher.
Oh, my God.
Just to get a few more mil.
That's so bad. Oh, there's a picture of Sam and Kurt.
Kurt's happy there.
They're happier.
I'd love to hear him talk about his game.
Yeah, we're trying.
Yeah, let me find a...
Yeah, you got to find a clip.
There, you don't have any?
He'd be so happy, I bet, right? He's all like, yeah, it's
great.
That was
going to be great.
Right. Well, we got food in front of us, so we'll break.
Ooh.
Maybe we'll have the clip of Kurt Schilling talking about this game that went belly up. He was on Sam's show right before the launch.
Oh, boy.
And, you know, we'll be doing Jocktober and other things today as well.
Ooh, yes.
It's a miserable story.
But it's frightening.
But doesn't it make
That's
you like...
a nightmare.
Doesn't it make... Because I'm very careful with shit like that. Doesn't it make you think, like, wow, I'm really glad I'm careful so far.
There,
like,
but for the grace of God,
yeah,
go
man,
I, as they say.
It's probably so easy to fall into that trap when you have that kind of money.
Right.
It's not easy to fall in that trap. He went all in. No one does that. I'm telling you.
But it's snowballs.
It's very rare.
I bet it snowballs.
Yeah, I bet Jimmy's
right. Something happens and it snowballs, and you don't want to lose $5 million, so you're like, oh, no, if I do this, that will cover it, and then fix that, and then the loan's guaranteed.
But I think his initial investment was pretty much all in, right, Travis?
I think so, yeah.
It wasn't like, okay, look, we're in a situation here. You're going to have to put more money in. It sounds like he put all of it in right away.
What a buffoon. Yeah.
It was a poor financial decision.
Of epic proportions.
And they might have said, dude, you can make... $500 million the
of
first
course.
Day.
Of course. That's what he was thinking. I'll be
Grand Theft Auto.
Oh, God.
I'll become a billionaire.
Yeah.
How much did it sell? Do we know?
How much did his game
sell?
Yeah,
like, what did it get to?
Oh, God.
Know. You're talking about an athlete, a really good athlete that won't even be a millionaire now when this is all said and done.
No, not even close. He's so in debt.
He'll be living in Ashland, where you used to live. Imagine.
Hey, I think that's Kurt Schilling. Yo, Kurt, you want to throw the ball around?
$713,000.
That was this year.
What?
The game? Rhode Island nets $713,000 from ongoing Kingdom of
Reckoning sales since the state acquired the assets last summer.
Jesus. That's nothing.
No.
Oh.
They're $100 million in debt.
Oh, man. Almost there.
He's probably going to get kicked out of Massachusetts on top of it.
Right? I don't know.
Rock, didn't GTA make $800 million the first day this year?
Some ridiculous number, yeah.
I wonder when he knew that this wasn't going to work, like the first day when they had like 41,000 in sales.
Oof.
All right, he said, Kurt Schilling tweeted... that it had sold 1.2 million copies by the 90-day mark.
Mm-hmm.
So let me do some math.
That's probably disastrous for that kind of money, right?
Probably. Let's see.
Well, the game would be, what, $50?
$50, so.
$60. So you're talking $60 million plus you had a little bit on there.
Yeah.
So that's about $72
million. $72
million? In 90 days.
That's horrendous.
GTA probably made that in 90 seconds.
Right. Mm-hmm. 90 days. Yeah, you're right. Okay, 90 days. He made... $72 million about.
Yeah, Rhode Island governor has said that the game was a failure as it needed to sell over 3 million copies to break even.
Yikes.
They did not break even.
Didn't even break even. Holy shit. Oh my God.
Bye bye.
All right.
That's why you don't get invested in your hobbies.
No. No. We got some Miley Cyrus audio. That's really good too. Mm,
goody.
She's talking to Matt Lauer about sex.
Oh, a row.
But it's making the rounds, this clip.
Row.
And
she's feisty.
And other things, right?
Sure. That's what I say. Mm. I'm psyched for Jocktober. It was fun yesterday. And then I was driving in, and I guess we had a lot of wind and stuff yesterday, the storm and everything. And every time I hear it, somebody said, yeah, and some trees fell on... some houses. I was just like, I got a tree on my house.
I got a tree on my house.
And then, of course, it goes hand in hand with, I want to see the boat movie.
God, does he stink.
Oh, that's so bad. I think I'm going to see the boat movie.
I want to see the boat movie.
After the show today.
Oh.
It's already out, the boat movie?
No, no. I got a preview.
Oh, nice.
A preview.
Very cool.
Yeah, the boat movie.
The Opie and Anthony Show.
Selling all your shit. You're the champ of selling your shit.
We were going to move on, but we found two quick clips of Curt Schilling.
I want to hear this.
On the Sam Roberts Show. Heard exclusively on the Opie and Anthony channel.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It's big news today. There's an estate sale going down Saturday in Curt Schilling's actual house, and he's selling all his junk. I mean, we just saw the website. Most of it is junk because he owes so much money.
Junk.
So, the you know, they're moving in to get as much as much money as they can from this guy, who's now bankrupt because of his video game company and his video game that went belly up.
Yeah, so...
But there was a time, right before the release of the game, before all this went terribly wrong, that he was excited and looking forward to the future, the success of the video game.
The money's gonna be a-rolling in.
I always enjoyed this. I think all of us have kind of fantasy in our DNA, whether it be science fiction or...
But the weird thing is that most of us who have fantasy in our DNA, we've...
Yeah, my fantasy doesn't involve losing everything.
Oh, not a good fantasy right there.
Yeah. Fantasize about, like, being a Major League Baseball pitcher or something like that. Well, there, like, generally speaking, giant sports star doesn't have to dive into a different world.
Good point, Sam.
Heeded the warning of Sam Roberts right there.
I had no idea how smart I was at that
time. That's right.
Yeah.
Well, so keep your fantasies a chick with dicks like the rest of us. Chick with dicks.
Just one of them.
I'm just a non-improving idiot.
So you were uncomfortable with this Curt Schilling thing. You're like, oh my God, what are you doing? Well, that's what I heard there. What are you doing? You're a baseball star. What are you? Why are you doing this?
Yes, because the whole idea of escaping into fantasy is to forget your day-to-day.
And you didn't know at the time that he put all his money in.
No, nobody did.
No one knew at the time, right? But so you think he might be a spokesperson, and even that, you're like, what are you doing? You're a baseball guy.
Well, I knew that he had an investment, and I knew that he had put a bunch of money into it. I didn't know everything. But, yeah, I was sitting there going, you know, you already got to be a pitcher for the Red Sox. Like, you already got to be a Major League Baseball star. You got the fantasy part of life. Now just go enjoy it. Stop trying to push the fantasy thing.
Right.
I hate you. What?
Why you hate me?
What are you talking about?
You just said
that. We're playing the Curt Schilling clip.
Oh, you're talking about it. Have to dive into it's a different world.
I've never worked a day in my life. I honestly haven't. I've never had to do something. I've always been able to love what it is I do. So
never too late to start now.
Yep.
Yeah.
Gonna be working you're going to be working pretty hard now.
Looking at those classified ads.
He had it all set up where he would never have to.
Oh, man.
Why would you screw it up?
Do something. I've always been able to love what it is I do. So 38 Studios was just, it was a stab at being, trying to be a world champion, I guess, at something else. And something no one gave me a shot at, something no one, I certainly didn't go in with out externally high expectations.
Well, yeah. Good.
But I've always, I've been a part of three world championship teams and been able to play around the best players in the world. And I wanted to take a chance on doing it someplace else.
Oh.
Well, you did.
Hey, take that chance. Yeah. See what happens. Oh, that's right.
Yeah, if you didn't go in with externally high expectations, maybe everything was too much.
Yeah.
Die.
Financially.
We got more from the Curt Schilling appearance on Sam's show.
Mean. Wait, does it become difficult to be anything but a champion after that? Like,
well, it's impossible.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like my wife runs marathons. Uh-huh. And she said, oh, you know, why don't you do this
with me? Sell her sneakers.
So let me explain how this works. If I'm halfway through a race and the winner's already finishing, I have no interest in playing.
Yeah,
I mean,
if I
don't have a chance to win, I don't want to play. And, you know, I think part of that is what I'm trying to bring to this company is making people understand limits and capabilities are all self-imposed.
Oh.
I like to win. I like I've certainly lost a lot. But baseball was very teachable to me.
More.
In the difference between losing and failing. In baseball, you lose, you win 50, you lose 50
Angry
every year,
birds,
and then it's
stuffed
the other
animal.
62 that kind of determine who wins.
50 cents.
So losses are kind of an everyday thing.
Yeah.
You don't accept it, but you understand
it's part of
life.
Flintstones, jelly jar glass, 75 cents.
This is great to listen to, knowing what happened.
In hindsight, yes.
Losses are part of life, huh?
Yes.
And he says what's self-imposed? Did he just
and then
said?
It's the other 62 that kind of determine who wins. So losses are kind of an everyday thing.
Yeah.
You don't accept it, but you understand it's part of life. Like, when I walk away from baseball, you have wins and losses every day. The only way to fail something is to quit.
Yep.
Right.
And I've never quit anything in my life.
Oops.
So this is we're in it for the long haul.
There are other ways
to
fail things.
In this game, the reviews have been unbelievable.
Oh.
See, he's thinking I'm in.
Here's the equivalent of losing in baseball. He plays for a team that goes 0-162. That's how bad this loss is.
Yes.
But every game they lost 1-0, 2-1,
right.
On a bad call.
Right. An error.
And yeah. He definitely thought that the reviews meant that he was going to sell a lot of games, because you don't go out and say, I did this so I could be the world champion of something else.
No, I don't care about the money.
I'm sure he had some kind of app on his phone. Like, let's break it down. He's probably somewhere celebrating the release of the game and just sitting back and waiting for the numbers.
Yeah.
When do you think he starts sweating?
5 minutes in.
5 minutes in?
We sold 9 copies.
Oh, boy. How many more we need to break even?
Right.
2,999,991.
Do you think by the end of the night he was out of his mind?
I guarantee they talked him down. Dude, you know what? GTA is an institution. People are used to that. This is going to be more word of mouth. This might take you, This is the long haul. All right. Yeah, they had those discussions.
Oh, yeah. It's not going to happen overnight. It's okay, though.
They probably prepared him for that first.
We got a good foothold in the industry.
Poor guy.
That's amazing. Yeah, in hindsight, it's pretty fucking interesting to hear him talk about the game like that.
Mm-hmm.
He did have some high hopes.
He thought he was going to be like he thought that he was going to be as successful at video games, if not more, than he was at baseball.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Well, good luck, bro.
Oh, shoot.